full of so many problems and difficulties. Vishwani Durgani. Durga Durgani means difficulties, problems in life. Life is full of problems. In fact, another name of life is problems. All of us know very well. If you drive out one problem, something else comes up. You drive it out, something else comes up. That is why our Yadishwaran used to say, the best solution to solving the problems of life is raising the mind above the problems. You remember the story of the two little children? They were in a garden, flower garden. They saw the fruit garden on the other side. There is a little wall in between. And they peeped over the wall and found a number of juicy fruits on the ground. They wanted to go and eat them. They tried, they couldn't climb the wall. One of the children came back weeping, but the second child was more enterprising. It found out one broken box and dragged it near the compound and then climbed over it, jumped to the other side and ate the fruits. Now this is the first part of the story. The first child was a defeatist. The second one was an entrepreneur. It was able to get the solutions for the problems. But the real story lies in the next part. After 10 years or 15 years, both the children have grown into young men, but the wall has not grown. Wall is the same height. Now what was an obstacle is no more an obstacle. They can just cross over like this. So the solution to the problems of life is not trying to find an antidote to every problem that comes. The best solution is to raise the mind above the problems. When the problems of life do not disturb you, you are called as a sthita prajna. Dukheshu anudvignamanaha sukheshu vigatasprihaha veta raga bhaya krodhaha sthitadhir munirucchate. What a beautiful description. Even if you don't read the Gita, it doesn't matter. If you go through the 18 shlokas of the second chapter towards the end, giving the sthita prajna lakshana, that will be enough. Ultimately, the mind must be in a balanced state, unaffected by the vicissitudes of life. Suppose you go to the sea, you are going to Kanyakumari. You want to take bath before having Devi's darshan. You go and sit on the bank of the ocean, the sea. You are terribly afraid. Waves after waves are coming. Suppose you want to sit and wait. Salpa ee alegulu kadimi aadmele snana maadthini antandre kadagaladarvu alle kulithirbekagutte. Because the nature of the ocean is such that the waves are part of the ocean, they will never die down. You have to brave the waves and enter into the water and get out. So if that bravery is there, courage is there, then you can achieve it. Similarly in life, you must be prepared to face the problems. But how to face the problems? There must be enough courage and strength. Mam anusmara yudhyacha. Remember me and fight. Sri Krishna was there with the Pandavas, all the while. But still, how many problems and difficulties and sufferings the Pandavas had to undergo? Namadida karma balavantavadari, nimanudenu hariye, Purandardasa challenges Lord Krishna. Yes, we understand, that is true. But when God created the world, He created it like that. It is the totality of the prarabdha karma of the individuals of the previous cycle who didn't get moksha, they were given one more chance. The way of the world is like that. So, just as we cross the river with the help of a boat, you kindly help us to cross over the problems and the difficulties of life, sufferings of life, by giving us full protection and leading us out of it. So that is the first mantra. And the commentators say, what are the real problems in life? The problems are not the difficulties that we face in life. These difficulties are results of our papa karmas. So ultimately what is to be tackled is papa itself and not the fruits and the results of papa karma. So he is praying to Agni to destroy papa itself. Yes, it is true that due to ignorance we have slipped from the path of rectitude. We have committed sins in life. We are suffering. I agree. But if the sufferings have to go, the root of the sufferings which lies in papa, papa karma or papa samskara must go. So you destroy that papa, papa samskara in our mind. Let the mind be purified and directed towards righteousness and dharma. And God has that power because it is God who created karma, karma theory and all those things. If he wants, he can give us double promotion, triple promotion. Nothing is impossible for God the Supreme. So that is one advantage in following the path of bhakti. Once we accept that God is supreme, he has the power to help us to transcend even the karma, the law of karma. Holy Mother says in one place, what Vidhi writes with the right hand can wipe it off with the left hand if it likes, if it wants. If a man has to lose his hand because of bad karma, by the grace of God it can be only a finger or it can be only a nail. What is needed is a heartfelt, sincere prayer. Or at least, if the effect of papa karma cannot be avoided, one can pray to God to strengthen the mind so that it can withstand the rigors of the effects of these papa karmas. All that depends upon the intensity of our prayer. Then we go to the second mantra. Tam agnivarnam tapasa jvalantim vairochanim karma paleshu jushtam durgam devihim sharanamaham prapadye sutarasitarase namaha. Agnivarnam tapasa jvalantim vairochanim karma phaleshu jushtam tam durgam devim aham sharanam prapadye he tarasi tarasvini su tarasi tubhyam namaha. That is the prose order. So this is the second mantra and the only mantra in the series of seven mantras forming the Durga Sukta that directly applies to Durga, Mother Durga. The commentators have explained beautifully that Durga is Paramatma's Kriya Shakti. Jnana Shakti is Saraswati, Jagat Rakshana Shakti is Lakshmi. Vishnu's business is to protect the universe. So the power of protection is represented by Lakshmi, and the power of knowledge, wisdom, which will help us to get out of this samsara chakra, is represented by Saraswati, and the power of action, activity, both for construction and destruction, it comes from Durga. So all the three are different aspects of the power of one and the same Supreme God, Paramatman, Parameshwara, Ishwara. He has got three functions apparently according to the Puranas, Srishti, Sthiti and Pranaya. The power with which he does these three duties is given three different names. So Durga is Kriya Shakti and Saraswati is Jnana Shakti, Lakshmi is Rakshana Shakti. Since God is one, the three Shaktis are also one. In fact, the Durga Saptashati, also known as Devi Mahatmya or Sri Sri Chandi, is devoted to the three deities, Mahakali, Mahalakshmi, Mahasaraswati. Mahakali rouses Lord Vishnu by coming out of him. He wakes up from sleep, destroys Madhukaitabha. Mahakali. Mahalakshmi is Ashtabhuja, Dashabhuja, Ashtadashabhuja Durga, Mahishasura Mardini. And the third aspect is Saraswati, who destroyed Shumbhani Shumbhan Raktabija. So you will see from that scripture that Lakshmi, Saraswati and Durga or Kali, they are all one and the same. So if people quarrel in the name of these deities, that means they are just ignorant children. These three are the three Shaktis of one and the same Lord, and the same Shakti or power of God, which is manifesting as Durga and Lakshmi and Saraswati, is also manifesting as Agni and Indra. It is manifesting as Agni here. Without Agni we cannot live. Agni is a basic, fundamental power necessity in life. And Indra is the power that rules over the heaven, the heavenly regions. Unless there is a king, nobody will follow any discipline. 90% of us are gentlemen because of the police and the public opinion. This is how one English essayist puts it. Once there is a description in the Reader's Digest, in the Boston city, there is a strike by the police. The police chief also was there in the strike. Within 24 hours, there was so much of havoc and crime. The very same people, well-dressed gentlemen, who used to come and purchase goods from the shops, started looting them. And that man had the conscience to realize his mistake. Immediately he withdrew it and put it down. And later, there is a failure of electricity in the New York City for about 7 or 8 hours. And it took them nearly 1 month to clear the streets. So that is the nature of the human beings. The Papa and Punya is there, the Papishtha's nature is always there, and there must be a danda to control it. A king is absolutely necessary. And if a king is absolutely necessary here, he is necessary there also. Because Swargaloka is always beset with problems and difficulties by the asuras. The devas and asuras are constantly quarreling. That is according to the Puranas. And the devas and asuras are here in our minds and hearts, they are also in the outside world. So the power that is manifesting through Agni here and through Indra there, that is also the same power of the Supreme Lord. So once we understand this, we can very well appreciate the name given to Durga Sukta. Though there are 7 mantras, out of which only 1 mantra is dedicated to Durga, and 1 mantra for Indra, and 5 mantras for Agni, the entire Sukta is called as Durga Sukta because Durga means the power of God, nothing else. Now we come to the word Durga itself. Dur dukhena gamyate prapyate asau. Why is she called Durga? It's very, very difficult to approach her very difficult to get her grace. That is one definition.
That means Durga is the fierce aspect, the aspect of destruction. Lord Shiva's Shakti, and Shiva is the deity for Pralaya, Samhara, Samharakarta. So naturally the power of Samharakarta is terrible. And if you want to please that Samharakartri, then we have to make lots of efforts, lot of pleading, lot of tapas. So she is called as Durga, one who is very difficult to approach, very difficult to please. But there is a more benign definition. According to that, Durga means one who helps us to destroy our problems, our difficulties, helps us to cross over the difficulties and problems of life. We have the beautiful Devi Bhagavatam. I have referred to this scripture in one of my talks during the Durga Puja. It is a Devi Bhagavata is a wonderful scripture devoted to the cult of Devi, and there is a controversy whether Bhagavatam means Devi Bhagavatam or Vishnu Bhagavatam. Though Vishnu Bhagavatam is more common, Devi Bhagavatam is also very much there. The story of Mahishasura, Shubha, Nishubha, all these things appear there in great detail, and the Durga Saptashati Devi Mahatma is almost a small condensation of that work. And Devi Bhagavatam is an encyclopedia of various aspects of spiritual life and upasanas and mantra shastra. It was printed long back by the Mysore Palace series, Jaichamraja Odeyar Granthamala. Most unfortunately, it has not been reprinted again. About the greatness of Durga, how her grace helps us to overcome the problems in life. There is a very interesting story in the Krittivasa Ramayana. Krittivasa Ramayana is like Tulsidas Ramayana and Kamba Ramayana in Bengali language. It is in blank verse, what we call as Ragale Chandas in Kannada. Something like the style adopted by Kuvempu in the Ramayana Darshanam. There this is mentioned. It comes in the Devi Bhagavatam also. Now Rama Ramana Yudha is going on, and Sri Rama is finding it very, very difficult to vanquish. Ramana is not an ordinary enemy. How many times I cut off his heads, the heads come back again. He is almost dejected. Then Narada comes and tells him, you worship Mother Durga, then she will give you the power to conquer Ravana. So that was Sharad Ritu. So in Sharad Ritu, Sri Ramachandra wanted to worship Durga. But Mother Durga goes to sleep after Vasant Ritu. In Sharad Ritu, she is asleep. There is an Ekadashi called Bodhini. Bodhini is that Ekadashi on which all the sleeping gods wake up. So when Rama wanted to perform the worship of Durga, she was asleep. What to do? The first thing he did was Bodhana, wake her up through mantras. That is when Durga Puja, the very first and the most important aspect of the Durga Puja ritual is Bodhana Kriya. So he first did Bodhana, then Mother Durga rose from her sleep, then he propitiated her through detailed worship as described in the Devi Bhagavatam. The mother was pleased, and then mother granted him the boon, the power to conquer and kill Ravana. There is Durga temple in Lanka. And Rama was a great Shiva, a devotee of Shiva and Durga. So he suddenly discovered with open eyes that Mother Durga was leaving his temple and crossing the floor, entering into Rama's party. But He was a brave, strong fellow, puffed up with egoism. He said, you want to go, you go. I can take care of myself, he said. It's very interesting how these things are described in the Puranas. Durga came over to Rama's side and all that. Here in Devi Bhagavatam, it is mentioned why or how or for what purpose we have to worship Mother Durga. Dukkha Daridriya Nashaya Sangrami Vijayaya Cha Krura Shatru Vinashartham Tathogra Karma Sadhani Durgaancha Pujayet Bhaktya Paraloka Sukhaya Cha. These are the fruits and the results. Dukkha Daridriya Nashaya. I want to worship Mother Durga. Yes, suppose there is sorrow and suffering, suppose there is poverty, penury, you worship the mother, she will give you relief. Suppose you are fighting a battle, it may be a physical battle outside, it may be a battle inside, it may be a legal battle, whatever it is you want to conquer in the battle, try to get the mother's grace by worshipping her. Krura Shatru Vinashartham. Suppose there are enemies who are giving you trouble, who want to destroy you, then Tatha Ugra Karma Sadhane. Suppose you have to undertake some work which is very difficult to accomplish, some work which is very dangerous, involves lot of problems and troubles and dangers, then also you can worship Mother Durga. And Paraloka Sukhaya Cha. Ultimately, if you want to go to heaven or get moksha, for all these results, you can take refuge at the feet of the Divine Mother Durga and pray to her and worship her. And in the Devi Bhagavata, the mantra is also given, which is to be used in the Durga Puja. Durga Trayati Bhaktam Yaha Sada Durgati Nashini Durgniya Sarva Vedanam Tam Durgam Pujayamyaham. Something like Mula Mantra. You see, in every one of these ritualistic actions, there is a mantra called Mula Mantra. The basic mantra related to the deity, which should be used frequently in that ritual. For japa, for homa, for tarpana and so on. This is the Mula Mantra that has been given there in the Devi Bhagavata. For instance, the Mula Mantra for Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna is Aim. Om Aim Sarva Deva Devi Surupaya Sri Ramakrishnaya Swaha. The Mula Mantra for Devi is Hrim. Now for Holy Mother we say Om Hrim, not Om I'm Hrim, only Om Hrim. Last time I corrected it, you remember. Om Hrim Sarva Deva Devi Surupini Shri Sharada Devi Swaha. The Beja Mantra Aim is also used for Mother Saraswati. So there is a Beja Mantra and there is a Mula Mantra also. Mula Mantra may be just the Beja Mantra or it may be much longer also. Now for instance Ganapati, Ganapati Homa is done, there is a work called Vasishtha Tantra. A very esoteric work. It's very difficult to get text also. But there are scholars even now who have the manuscript and then perform Ganapati Homa according to that. And there is a long mantra given as the Mula Mantra for Ganapati. They repeat that mantra while pouring oblations into the fire. And that also, you see, there are different ways and methods of oblations for different fruits and results. If it is for wealth, in one way. If it is for curing the disease, in another way and so on. So this is the Mula Mantra that is prescribed by the Devi Bhagavata.